It's Patrick. He did it.
I'm having him.
His alibi holds up.
I want to help catch him.
But we need you all to be scared of this guy.
The cat is probably something her imagination has manufactured to soften the journey.
We've all put our neck in a noose for this kid, so there's no going back.
You all right, sir?
She's missing.
It's Wednesday the 17th of September and you're here with Andy Eden and the all-new crew brought to you in association with Reddy's. And it's a bit cold out there, so if you're smart, and you must be because you're listening to us, stay tucked up in bed and let us take care of you for the next 2 hours. All right, here's a classic from the 80s to get us started and you're here with Andy Eden and the all-new crew.
Stand back, please. I'm a police officer.
I didn't get a chance to stop. He just stepped out and...
I need an ambulance. Bridge Street, pedestrian hit by a car. Dead on impact.
Bloody hell. Bloody hell.
Right, move back to your car.
Bloody nerve of it. He had no right to do this to me!
Easy.
5 bloody times this has happened to me before.
You've run over 5 people.
No, on the trains, love. Driver for 20 years got post-bleeding trauma because of folk like him walking onto the tracks, the big goodbye.
You're saying he deliberately stepped in front of your car?
Split second before I hit him, and all I see is him mouthing, sorry, and then wham, sorry! Like, that's going to make it all better.
I know a lot of you have pulled all night as you're running on fumes. But there's that window between when he grabs them and when he kills them. And it's not much. It's getting smaller. We're running out of time. God knows, I don't want to be thinking about what Teresa Adamson is going through right now at his hands. I've looked through my big book of inspirational speeches from Winston Churchill to Glenn Hoddle, and it comes down to this. We can do this. We can find her. We can bring her home. I have to, because we're her only hope. Go make her proud, yeah?
Dana, I'm going to need you and Joy to head over to the parents.
Hey, need a door knocker. Suicide, Jeffrey Brazier stepped in front of a car.
Cheers.
Please don't tell me you're tramping his remains through the station.
Can we put out a disclaimer? No psychics required. We've had 3 phone calls already this morning. They're all talking out their asses. But... what's wrong with your shoes?
Ma'am, here's a nice cuppa for you.
Just to pick you up because of what's happened. Because of what's happened with Laurie.
Good night, was it? Got pissed up, rolling around the streets, relieved yourself against a car. Oh, no, a police car, no less. And then gave the arresting officer the verbals. Take me down, go ahead, I effing dare you.
I had a few drinks, a band practice. A few too many. Way, way too many. I'm sorry, I'm an embarrassment. Total disgrace.
I've seen you drunk, properly drunk. Bones of rubber, drooling like a scouser. You're the happiest guy in the room. Never snap, never snarl, let alone get gobby with a police officer of all people.
Jesus Christ, Viv, can I not just be an arsehole for once? There doesn't have to be a hidden meaning with everything.
I don't believe you. I've got a missing girl. 100 things to juggle. Can't deal with 101. I'll come back when you stop spinning me a line.
Come on.
The chief noticed I was gone last night.
A bit gentler, yeah?
I'm sorry. It's just... our cheese is very tidy. Place for everything, everything in its place.
It might be easier if you wait downstairs.
all. Go on, it's a direct order. Eyes front.
Went on and on about this. I told her it was too expensive and then...
I thought you'd surprise her.
What did he do to the other girls?
Susan.
I need to know.
You don't. Really.
He's got her right now and I'm standing here and she's so sweet and silly, you just wouldn't want to hurt her. You couldn't. Just don't understand.
We're doing everything we can to get her back. I promise.
I told her to get out there, enjoy herself. That she's a person and not something to be pitied and... just go out and be stupid and normal like everyone else. I... Oh, God.
Hate being a door knocker. Feels like I should have a cloak and scythe.
I've just put the kettle on.
We're sorry to inform you that your son was killed in a road accident.
He didn't suffer. It was instant.
Biscuits?
Sorry, can you turn it on?
Oh, I always forget. World of me own.
So you didn't hear anything we just said?
No. But I know why you're here. We're behind on the lecky. I said to my David and his missus, if you don't pay up, they'll send the boys in blue round.
Is Mrs. Brasher home? David's wife? Maybe better we speak to her first.
She's still in her bed. She's been poorly.
Hello, Mrs. Brasher. Are you decent? It's the police. Mrs. Brasher.
Ah, fuck. It's cold as ice, mate.
No, I didn't. I didn't even know she had a diary.
Do you have any idea what these letters mean?
Does Teresa have a friend who might know?
Might be able to help us understand the diary.
Maybe Olivia. Olivia Bacon. They're pretty close. Have we got a number somewhere?
Don't worry. We'll treat her with respect.
She's going to be so mad we went through her room. Won't she, Suze?
From a recent kidney operation. Very recent. Infection, onset of shock, low blood pressure, hidden heart condition, or any other wonderful variables. I'm ruling out this hideous wallpaper being responsible, but that's about it.
How about the husband, then? Did her in and ran off?
Oh, such a morbid imagination now. Might have woken up next to the body or gone downstairs, come back and... Definitely one for us lads to look into, though. Something rotten in the state of Primark, as the good bard said. No hospital would have released her that soon after major surgery. Not in that state, never.
Oh. Sorry, she got away from me. Mrs. Brasher, we can't be here. Oh. Come on.
Olivia?
It's a code. I showed her how to do it.
How does it work?
It's easy. One letter forward.
And what did Teresa need a code for, Olivia?
She didn't want her parents to know.
I have found a prince.
Did Teresa mention having a boyfriend?
No, but someone was very keen.
And how did they meet?
They haven't.
But they were going to.
He says that I'm a clever girl and that we'll be together forever.
Did she say anything else about him?
She said she was happy. She wanted a boyfriend.
Handyman and Princess Tessa forever. Does that mean anything?
Princess Tessa is a nickname.
Connie, could you take Olivia up for a cup of tea or something?
You gonna find her?
We're gonna try. Okay.
Princess Tessa with a Z and Handyman together bring up one search result. Both got profiles on the same dating website.
That special someone where barriers mean nothing.
Find out who owns that website. We need full access. Keys to their dirty little kingdom. Check and see if there's any similar sites out there. Might have multiple profiles. Like you and your internet dating phase.
Which we said we weren't ever going to speak about again.
Mum, Laurie's been asking for you. Well, unless he's hung himself by his shoelaces, I'm not interested. He's not, has he?
He just wants a word.
Well, so does the rest of the world right now. I'm just brutally honest. Out of 10, how do I look?
7.5?
I like a man who's unconcerned about promotion.
We are appealing for the public to be vigilant, to report anything suspicious.
Someone out there knows this person. They might not realise it, but they do.
And their phone call could be the key to successfully finding Teresa Adamson.
She's a scared, vulnerable... Sorry, Jim. Boring you, am I?
No, just breaking news, Viv.
That's Inspector to you. And this is breaking news, you div. What do your paper lead on this morning? Splash about some curry tart falling out of a nightclub with the Golden Globes hanging out.
They've found the girl. Sorry, Inspector.
Viv.
What are you doing to help protect other girls like Teresa, Inspector?
Are you wanted inside? It's urgent.
Right, so the husband saw something floating in the canal. He's dived in, not realising, well, that it'd always be too late. And then he found the need to tweet about it. Hashtag dead body. That's not sarcasm, by the way. That's actually happened.
House to house, 2 mile radius.
Phone back garden hedges. Help the council to have drains checked, see if the bins have been picked up.
Evidence. Did he tweet about it before or after he called the police?
Well, he was waiting for them to arrive. Brother-in-law's a journo. Word spread like dysentery in a bedsit.
I can help break it to Kathy if you like, just in case she takes it badly.
No, better it comes from me.
Might not be a bad idea to hear it from a sergeant, officially. I mean, clinical, professional.
She is our star witness. We don't want her falling apart at the seams.
She's handling this better than any of us would. Trust me.
When I was 19, my mum was still buying bras and knickers for me.
You okay?
I don't know, do I? I feel like I want to smash something. Someone.
Well, it's okay to feel angry. Shouldn't hold back.
This session with people, I'm going to get her to rip my skull open. Because I feel like it's down to me, isn't it? To remember his face and all that. I'm sitting here thinking what I'd do to this guy if I had the chance. What about you? 5 minutes alone. What would you do? I guess I'll just go play then.
Noise complaints, abuse, all sorts.
We'll take it from here.
Thank you.
What are you doing?
Whoa, 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 what's going on here?
He not pay us. Say the money ran out.
I paid you yesterday.
Then we stay another day.
Hey, don't.
What's all that about?
You should see the other fellow.
Why? Has he got a micro penis as well?
Oh, it's not mine, it's theirs.
Out.
Seriously?
I demand to see top lawyer. You are bullshit people.
Przecież to Eugenia. No to, czy ma bożeną kotka, uzmyśni siel I może ci siel upecze.
You're very super at your job.
So, what did we pull the kid in for? Says here he paid the hotel bill in advance, so we're not going to throw the book at him for calling up a couple of projects.
It's Franny Lowry, of the Cinderblock Lowrys. Honours degree in fucking up from the University of Life. Currently sleeping off the mother of all comedowns.
So where does 19-year-old Franny get the money to pay for a week in a luxury hotel? Said he'd been in a fight.
Well, yeah, he said. He had a massive scar here, recent.
Have you seen Jonah or Taz?
I'm pretty sure you're not allowed in here.
That body this morning, wife of the suicide, it had a scar, right? Operation. Across the kidney?
Yeah, she's in the autopsy queue behind the poor Downs girl, obviously. Water's on the fritz at home.
You've got photos of it, right?
The plumbing?
The scar?
Yeah, they're on file. I'll show you.
So, we've got the hotel, the room service, two ladies of the night. Comes to about £2,000, which you paid.
Cash in hand. A lot of loose coins to have jangling in your pockets,
Franny.
I want it.
That the book is? The thing is about a win like that, is we would have
heard about it. Everybody would have heard about it.
Do you know what this is?
Nah,
it's not yours, but that look just told me volumes.
I can't believe I'm gonna ask this. Did you sell
your own kidney for cash, Franny?
You know it's legal, right? Even if it's your own. Conspiracy to commit GBH.
Jail sentence, that. All we need is a name, a number. You set it all up.
Told you, I won it.
At the bookies.
Look, I'm a realist. I know you're not gonna sign witness statements, stand up in court. Pipe dream that. You're a Lowry. And your dad and brother will have filled your head about how a real man keeps his mouth shut.
Does his time without complaining. But you never been to prison before, have you?
3 years, Franny. Why don't you try talking? Bring those years down.
Unfortunately, Teresa's autopsy didn't throw up anything unexpected. She died the same way as the other girls. Sexually assaulted, then drowned. No DNA, no traces. You're looking into this website, then?
Still trying to find the owner.
Do you mind? Would you mind? It's all right, I know what I'm doing. See, hacking into a website is basically the same principle as cutting into bodies. You try to be precise, not to cause too much damage on the way in.
That makes sense.
No, I'm just saying that. I thought it sounded good. Totally different, really.
They think this website's from out of Eastern Europe.
Yeah, I reckon that's a schmuck screen.
What makes you say that?
Because just below the terms and conditions, which nobody ever reads, they've also written, come on the Dale. Rochdale AFC, right? 36 consecutive seasons in the bottom division, but we're on the rise now. Definitely sounds local to me. Of course, you'll want to check with the cyber guys that it's okay for me to proceed and dig deeper.
Fuck 'em. That's my motto. Name an address as soon as you can.
I took a loan out with Redis. You know, you got the talking chipmunk. And they kept sending me warning letters, pay up your dick. Now, I'm on my fourth, and then this guy calls up, offers to help. Well, he says that if I, you know, cash in hand, no questions. Well, Well, that's all. Oh, for fuck's sake. Oh, for fuck's sake. That's not fair. I don't know anything else.
Name and number.
I don't know what to make me more nervous. The fact that if we screw this up, we don't have a case, don't have evidence. Oh, that feels like the start of the worst blind date ever.
How's Bob doing, by the way?
So how many times this week you've
blown him off?
I beg your bloody pardon? You naughty bastard.
I've been cancelled on him.
Back on the clock, incoming to your right.
Sarah Ward?
Hiya.
Yeah.
So, Fanny Lowry gave him my number. He shouldn't have. It's not how I do things. How do you know?
My cousin used to go out with him.
Condolences. Just wondering how we get from that to this here.
Because he's got big mouth. Because I'm desperate.
Get a payday, Lal. Tide you over.
OK, reel him in. A bit more vulnerability.
Like, I'm ever going to be able to pay that back. Jesus, the roof's leaking, I've got a kid taking on another, and every morning I wake up and it's like someone's choking me.
You live around in the black wire, yeah?
Born and bred for my sins.
Buy me a couple of bodies and coke, and that size will come out. Believe me. Look, Fanny just said if I needed cash, you were the guy to see.
Give me fucking words, you shut your fucking mouth. Why you look?
Shit.
Diana, I think he's clocked me.
I'm screwed here. Please, I'm fucking drowning. That's it.
How much would you be looking for?
All the time on the case. Yes. Hey! Fucking shut up!
Sarah. Good. Pretty convincing. If someone was doing what I think you were suggesting, what's the crime? Really?
We're talking about people who are so desperate they'd sell their own kidneys.
They'd be cramped in here for a high horse.
Miriam Brazier. Remember her? Found dead in her bed after botched aftercare.
Yeah.
Doors opening.
You've got nothing.
You've got my wire.
And it's raining. And it's cold. And I'm pissed off. And there's a van. And he's stopping. And he's saying something. And there's that cat. Bloody cat. Dressed up. Bow tie.
Try to look up. Try to see his face.
I'm trying. He's there. I can see him. He's... Fuck! What's wrong with me? A hand, a mouth, a cat, that fucking cat! Oh, it's nothing!
You're getting closer, you're filling in the blanks.
Closer's nothing. He's gonna rape and kill another girl and it's my fault, see? My fucking slow head, my brain!
We always knock.
Sorry, ma'am. Just your husband's been asking for you again.
He picked the wrong bloody day.
And Dinah and Spike are back. Sting was a bust.
Of course he was. That kind of day. Here's what's worrying me. I think this Andrew's doing a hit and run. Two kidney incidents in 1 week. Sweeps in, secures the operations, then he's gone. Vapor, dust. Now he knows we've rumbled him.
Yeah, because I've blown the cover.
No. You did the right thing steaming on in, Charlie Bronson. But he'll be pulling out ASAP.
Lobel was a burner, pay as you go. No address, and now out of service.
Hey, you've still got that Reddy's connection.
Henry Lowry and Miriam Brasher both live in Sims Block, right? Well, both also have payday loans with Reddy's.
And are both on their fourth warning letter, which the locals call the Angry Chipmunk.
But the thing is, Andrew got in touch with Franny, not the other way around. So, how did Andrew know that Franny was in debt?
Let's get a warrant for the Reddy's client list. Cross-reference final warnings with Cinderblock Residency. If there's someone else that Andrew's trying to contact.
Do you mind if I do it, ma'am? It's just that fucking chipmunk. It brings out the rage in me.
I need you for a taxi run.
Where's the pickup?
That self-pitying little shit, Patrick Llewellyn. Miller's grabbed some profile pics from the dating website. None of them seem to match the e-fit, but you never know. Maybe one of them will ring a bell for Patrick.
On it.
On it. Do like me a bit of macho talk.
Viv.
No. No, I'm not interested.
I don't even know what I'm going to say.
Even though you don't realise it, you need Laurie's support. By keeping him in the cells, you're not just punishing him, you're punishing yourself.
I probably wouldn't have made it so mushy, though.
Well, you would. It might have worked. But we're the jugglers here and the circus is only going to get busier. Stuart and Tegan are en route to bring in the owner of the website, Roland Stubbs.
Want me to have a crack at him for you?
Oh, she reads my mind, anticipates my moves. It's like Tovel and Dean dancing the bloody bolero.
Bit before my time, that one. You look like a dog trying to do long division.
I saw the photo my dad sent you.
Oh.
I don't know what he was thinking.
No, you've only responded in kind.
Wait, you sent my dad photos of yourself? Why?
Because he asked.
Well, you've not?
No. Not yet, anyway. Can we just focus it? Because for all we know, this website guy could be the one who killed those girls. You know, if he comes lunging at me, if he's cocked up between his legs and a meat cleaver in his hands, I'd rather have backup that wasn't obsessing over his dad's sex life.
What?
Why did you start the website, Roland?
I don't know if it was other people or me. I was just struggling to meet, you know, girls. Turned out it was a total sausage fest anyway, and...
Do you know a user called Handyman?
That's what you want to see me about? He's the one who you think with the girl?
Roland, what did you do? Roland clocked Handyman straight away because he was very specific. Downs only. Like, keeps trying to get Handyman to upgrade to Platinum membership. Handyman won't. So Roland, annoyed, thinks about banning him. But then decides to mess with him instead. Creates a fake Downs girl, Patty, who agrees to meet Handyman for a date. September the 6th. The night Kathy was taken. Right. Here. The Laughing Dog pub, where Patty agreed to meet Handyman, and just a few streets away, Belvedere Road, where Kathy was abducted. So say Handyman goes there, yeah? Waits for Patty, who never arrives, obviously. Well, he's frustrated. All dressed up, nowhere to go. Takes a drive. It was raining. Visibility was low.
Mistakes Kathy for one of his type. We take control of Patty's profile. We send Handyman a message, apologise, ask him for another chance. See if we can't coax this bastard out of whatever rabbit hole he's hiding in.
Sorry, ma'am. There's been a hiccup with the Reddy's warrant.
I'll pretend I didn't hear that, Joy.
So, you know, you filled out the paperwork for the warrant and then passed it off to me to get to the magistrate?
Yeah.
I sort of forgot about it.
You forgot about it?
It's been sent off now. I'm sorry, I've just had a lot on my plate. I'm really sorry.
Right, then, well, clear your bloody plate! Without that warrant, that whole organ case is grinding to a halt. Shit, it's gonna skin me. We're never gonna get it in time now.
I'm sleeping in my car.
What? Has something happened between you and Rosie?
No. Sorry, I made that up. Up there with dog ate me homework or big boy did it and ran away.
Jonah.
And you won't need a warrant for the Reddy's case because they won't want the bad publicity. They'll hand over the list. If the other option's them having the name splashed all over the papers. And honestly, what I said about sleeping in my car, I don't know where that came from. I screwed up, that's all.
Right, call Reddy's main office, say what you just said. Get them to agree access because we need their client list. And Jonah, if you do need to talk.
Nothing to talk about, ma'am.
Want to shut that thing off?
Oh, God, that stupid chipmunk's voice in my head.
It's technically a squirrel and not chipmunk. They've got him dancing around in a tree. It's the squirrels that build their homes in the branches. The chipmunks, they live underground.
One more to check out.
Roger, fingers crossed for that. What's the story with this one?
Alison Carey, 36. Still got outstanding debts with Reddy's. Got her fourth warning 3 weeks back. Or fifth warning. Send a guy in a chipmunk costume around to break your legs.
No. I've not. Nobody's been in touch or nothing.
Is your husband around?
He's away working. In the building trade.
Away being...
Germany.
Oh, yeah. I heard a lot of the lads were going over recently. They're helping do that new Ausgaben Bank head office.
That's right, yeah.
And let me tell you about this guy. He finds someone in debt on the estate, an easy target, desperate, ready to crumble.
Told you, it's not me. Ausgaben Bank head office. Pull that one out of my ass.
A woman's died. A few streets over, Miriam Brasher sold her kidney, then bled to death internally in her own bed. That could so easily be your husband.
Look, I know how you feel.
Really? You know, dear, because I have dreams, proper, real dreams, about smothering my own kids, myself, just so that I can be free of all this. For one fucking day where I am not scared shitless. Ryan's tried to get a job. Look, you're not here to help. You never are.
No, you're right. We're not. We're here to warn you that this man doesn't give a shit about you and your family. Your number's in a margin to him. Your profit. This is what you're risking.
I thought that photo thingy nearly worked. Or the speech?
Maybe. One. Or the other.
Oh, we follow her instead.
Maybe she's worried enough to go see her husband, or...
Or something else.
You laid it on a bit thick, you know. Today, all right. The operation. It's happening today.
She hates me, doesn't she? Your boss. I can tell.
No, that's just the way. Short, sharp, to the point.
It's all right. Don't like her much either.
Anything?
anyone here in particular that you want me to point out? Just say the word.
No. No, Jesus, no. Just tell us if you think any of them are the guy you saw.
Honestly, I'm trying, but... No.
The arresting officer's been shagging someone else behind his missus's back.
You blackmailed him into letting me go, did you?
I persuaded him to save on paperwork. People lie to me every day, Laurie. You get into a kind of mindset.
There's no need to apologise, love.
Who's apologising? I'm saying I don't believe you. I think there's other reasons why you got out your tree and went off like that.
Look, I pissed against a police car because... I don't like the police. They've taken my wife away from me and I don't know how to talk to her about it.
How have they taken me away?
It's like you're not here anymore, Viv.
Maybe that's because here is where we let a defenceless girl down. Where the best we could do was have her dragged out of the cold water. I'm not taking that home. Sorry. No.
Tell you what. Name 10 people whose cars you want pissing on. And I'll do it.
Make it 25 and you got a deal.
That guy here is going to take you home. Hey, listen, don't beat yourself up about it. You did your best, OK?
Thanks.
Hey, Laurie, you big fanny. Maybe you got the hangover to end all.
Yeah, and then some for me sins.
You're live on air, caller.
Location of operation confirmed. Kicking off now, we're heading over.
We've got a big one.
Yep.
I'll see you at home, OK?
Oh, wait in the car, OK?
With the money, there's no way I still get it.
All right, sweep in. Cover the exits.
Nowhere to run, nowhere to hide.
Find out who these lovely people are.
Will do.
Shut it down.
Hold up.
Hold up a moment.
I think we've got a runner. I'll go round the back.
It's not just a removal.
Got eyes. We thought it was Harvest Festival, didn't we? But it's a recycling bank.
That's the recipient's family. The NHS won't even put him on a transplant list.
Low chance of success, wasted resources.
And if we put a stop to this, kidney goes for nothing.
Unless the transplant was in progress when we arrived.
Yeah. We both know you're in trouble. So I'd focus if I were you. I'd really bloody focus.
Anything?
Nothing. Wait. First floor! Andrew!
You look nice. Like a barber copper. It suits you.
And there was me about to arrest you, but seeing as you've got such a sweet mouth...
Look, no matter what you think about me, I did those people a favour.
Why don't you just let me bring in, Andrew?
Well, hang on. You've seen the state of places like Cinder Block, yeah? If you're born there, your life expectancy takes a 10-year hit right off the bat.
And that's before someone like you sweeps in to exploit the situation, right?
There are places in India where half the village have sold organs. Half the village. For what? 300 quid a pop. I paid 2,000.
And how much do you sell them on for?
Andrew, what's your plan here? Hoping to lecture us to death?
See, she understands. She pretends she doesn't, but... And she was telling me that whole spiel about the kids, about how she feels like she's drowning. She meant every word. Didn't you? You're as desperate as they come.
Oh, God!
All I did was ask for a photo of your dad, and you assault like a 12-year-old.
A naked photo of my dad, Tegan. Who, by the way, uses women like Kleenex. Does his business with them, crumples them up, tosses them aside. I've seen it all my life.
Oh, okay, so this is real concern for me, this, isn't it? And not your screwed-up daddy issues.
Not concern, pity. You did the son, now you're gonna do the father.
Yeah, do you know what? You can fuck off and all.
Yeah, fine by me.
Are you sure you're all right? Some hit. Look, I'm sorry I froze back there.
No, it was great. See, that's my job. If any of you lot freeze, I have to act. And I knew that before, but suddenly all just clicked.
At least until we went through that glass, and then I was just like, that was stupid.
That's Patty, ready for reactivation.
Go for it.
And Joy said, let there be light, and there was light.
What happened? I got overconfident. Tried petting a wounded animal.
Might want to sit down.
Drink that while you're getting ready. I'm taking you somewhere special tonight and no arguments.
Is Kathy home?
Yes, she's upstairs, I think. Dinah.
I saw the video. You and Dr. Peep.
She okay?
What do you think? Look at me sometime, Kathy. You can't pretend this didn't happen. Look, I know you're frustrated.
No, you don't know about me. How I feel. You treat me like I'm some fucking puzzle to be solved.
I don't.
I enjoyed it. Hitting her. Slapping her. Knowing she wasn't going to fight back and... I'm going to go stay at Alpha's.
I'm upset, but I'm not throwing you out.
I have to anyway.
Why? Why do you have to go?
A few months now.
Oh, Kathy.
Don't worry. It's Alpha's. It's over the moon. It's going to be a great dad. The enthusiastic twat. I bet you're kind of relieved, right? Not going to be your responsibility no more.
You leaving?
Yeah.
Do you want me to give her a lift?
I've been called into work. It's okay. No, I'm a nightmare.
Same time tomorrow, yeah?
What, when you say you've cooked me dinner? Yeah? Takeaway's not the same thing. Listen, I've got a dash, there's something big going on here. Well, I'll tell you later. Now say you love me and piss off, eh? I should have had him arrested months ago. Perfect husband.
Right, so here's the news. We got a hit 20 minutes ago. Handyman sent a message to Patty. Oh, what's he been saying?
Hey, sexy. Pause of 34 seconds. Where you been? Pause of 1 minute, 40 seconds. Usually don't give girls who stand me up a second chance. Might make an exception for you, if you're lucky.
Did we reply back?
Just a smiley, one of them that's winking and blowing a kiss at the same time. Thought it best to start slow, make him do a bit of work for my attention, keep him interested. And apparently he is.
He's agreed to a date.
You know where we live? Gone after me wife. I mean, they've gone after Elizabeth.
This is not justice. He should never have been released.
Whoa, get off me, you mad bitch.
Why would I know what he'd done?
Are you threatening me?
I think so.
For exclusive interviews with Paul Abbott and the cast of No Offence, head to channel4.com/No Offence. Tomorrow night at 9, 24 hours in A&E is back with a bang, quite literally. The brand new series kicks off with injuries that'll make you think twice before climbing any 20-foot trees. Next tonight, the Cats try their hand at Countdown.